My name is Sven. Normally we should have the talk on OpenMS and asterisks here, but the speaker is sick, so yeah, I jump in here. This is a highly improvised talk, as Markus told me about me holding this talk about 15 minutes ago. Sorry?
So you say that this is improvisation, and why do you have the slides?
Because I spent the last 15 minutes putting the slides together. Yes. So it's not much. I will give you a very basic overview about the RIPE Atlas project. I got involved with the project, or let's not say I'm involved with the in the project. I'm running a RIPE Atlas node for about half a year now, and I met one of the responsible persons at RIPE for the project at the KAIST Communication Congress in Hamburg this year, and got in touch with her, talked a bit about the project, and told her that we have that conference here, and that it would be nice to have some of the RIPE Atlas probes as a giveaway. And so we got 10 of the probes. Some of you got one of the probes yesterday in the evening event as the prize for the challenge. And we thought maybe I should tell you some words about the probes so you know what it is about and what you can do with it. So RIPE had the idea of building a distributed monitoring infrastructure to monitor the internet. It's about measuring the internet in real time and about getting an idea of how traffic flows through the internet and how services are being accessed from different subnets, from different autonomous systems. For example, if you are sitting in this autonomous system, is another autonomous system reachable from there? Which DNS servers are accessed from there? Is the K-root server accessed, or is the A-root server accessed, or whatever? And to get a picture of all that, they started to build a distributed monitoring infrastructure. The project started in 2010. Some of the requirements for the project were they needed a probe. It should be small. It should be easy to deploy. It should be USB powered, and it should be capable to run in yeah, the whole year, every day, 24 hours a day. And the result of this are those tiny little probes here. The probes are hosted and sponsored by ISPs, by internet exchange points, and mostly by normal people like you and me. This is the version number one of the probe. So this, what I have in my hand is actually the version two of the probe. So the data here is not the actual data of the new one, but it's the only data I found in the last 15 minutes. So the version one probe is this hardware here. It's very low power usage, 8 MB of RAM, 16 MB of flash. It runs Micro Linux. The reboot is very fast, as you can see here. And the version two probe, I forgot to put this on the slide. I think the version two probe is using a power consumption of about 1 or 2 watt. So you can just plug it into the USB port of your server, put a network cable in it, and run it there. Some security considerations. It's a hardwire trust material here. So all the keys for the RIPE servers, all the IP addresses and everything is hard-coded here in hardware. So there is nothing that can be hacked and switched to another channel or something. There are no open ports on the node. That was when I got it, I had no idea what to do with it. So I plugged it in and I did a port scan on it, and I thought, well, okay, what's this? I can just trash it or something. And then I started reading some material at the RIPE homepage, and so I learned about how to use these nodes. Cool aspect of this is that it works with NAT. So if you are having a home network and a NAT router at home, you can just plug it in, give it a local IP address, nobody has to connect to it via an SSH connection or something. The probe initiates connections to the outside. All the measurements are scheduled by a centralized command server. This is done by the probe doing a connection to the outside and then using an SSH reverse connection. And the probe doesn't listen to local traffic, so you can say, we do not sniff your traffic, but if you trust this or if you check it using Wireshark or anything, is up to you. But for me, I'm trusting RIPE at this point. And also, I'm running the node not at home, but here at the university. So if they are sniffing, they're sniffing the university's traffic. The goal of the project was to get 1,000 nodes up in the, was it about 500 nodes in the first year? We are now at over 2,600 nodes up, and interestingly, about more than 1,000 nodes have IPv6 enabled. This is not true for the node I'm running here at the university because we are very restrictive with IPv6 here at the university. And there are four types of measurements the node can do. This is ping, traceroute, DNS, and SSL. All the services also can be done with IPv6, of course. So the probe can ping to any destination. It can traceroute to any destination. It can do DNS requests. And it, the SSL measurement here is to measure the certificate. So getting the certificate and doing a validation of the certificate. All measurement data is publicly available, and everyone can participate in the project by just going to atlas.ripe.net/apply and apply for your own node. So if you did not get a node and you want to check it out, do some tests with it or something, just go to the address, register there. You have to create a RIPE account and check some checkboxes that you want to participate in the project. And I think it will be 2 weeks or 3 weeks or something, and they send you a note to your preferred destination completely with no cost, not even for the post. So that was my presentation. It was really not much. And now I would say I go to the RIPE homepage and show you something about the nodes. So this is a map of all the, I reload the page. This is a map of all active probes here in Europe. So it's some of them. And if we go to Germany, for example, there is Fulda here. We can see that there are some probes in Fulda. I think this one is mine here in the university. The other one is Dustin's. And I think the other two nodes are running at NetSyncs. I think it's the IP range of NetSyncs. So you can click here and get some basic information about the node. This is the IP range of the university here, so this is one of my nodes. There are also...
Please show me this from our company.
This one? 212.218, I think that's common IP range.
Maybe it's mine.
Oh, okay.
It's not yours.
Well, there are some statistics here at the RIPE page. The probe deployment, so this is very interesting, as it shows that my numbers weren't completely correct. I think here, somewhere here is the initial goal, but you can't even see the line because it's, is it in another graph? I don't know, maybe they put it out. So you see that the distribution of the nodes is constantly growing. Probe deployment, we have active users here at the RIPE Atlas homepage. The firmware versions. Interesting about this is that RIPE is pushing a new firmware to the nodes remotely. So actually you can't do very much with the node itself. You can control the node using the RIPE Atlas homepage. I will show you the interface in a minute. And everything is everything, every interaction with the node is done via the RIPE Atlas interface, web interface, and also RIPE is pushing new firmware to the nodes remote. Yes?
I don't understand one thing. How to activate the code? I need to register on the or is automatically activated?
Yes. You are registering at the RIPE Atlas homepage. Then they apply a node to you. They send it to you via UPS or something. Sorry?
Otherwise, if you don't apply, it should not work.
If you do not apply at RIPE, then first thing is you do not get a probe. And second thing is that it just don't work because you do not have access to the web interface of RIPE.
I got the probe yesterday.
Okay, I can show you this also in a minute. All the probes we handed out to you are registered to me at the moment. But this also means this also means that you are not able to configure your own measurements because it's registered in my RIPE account. So I log in and I see your probe. If you plug it in, I can add measurements at your probe at your home or wherever you plugged it in. So. When you want to get nodes, you have to register. And as we did not know who of you wants to get a node or gets a node from us, I registered all of them to my name. As soon as you create an RIPE Atlas account, you can re-register the node by its MAC address that is printed on the node to your private account. Then it will disappear in my account and go to your account.
The fact that I own the physical device can help me in. Because I want to use this probe inside a network, very small internet provider in Italy. It would be nice to have such a super nice product, but I don't want to give it a probe that is not this okay. Thank you.
Yeah. But we can talk afterwards, and I can tell you about my experiences so far. Okay, so I go to the next page here, the maps page. There is one page that I personally find very interesting. That's the DNS root instances page. This is showing which root DNS server instance the probes are querying. So if you are running a probe at home or you are running a probe at the university or whatever, you see what DNS root instance your probe is using when doing DNS queries. So when I zoom in a bit here, we have a legend here, what root server they are. So AMSX, that's the kroot server instance in Amsterdam at the IMSAIX Internet Exchange. There is the DENIC one that's connected at the D6 in Frankfurt. So this is an Anycast IP address and the different probes connect to different of the Anycast IPs, as you can see here. That's I think it's an interesting picture of measurements you normally don't see because you don't know which internet exchange points or which internet providers use which best routing strategies or whatever, and you can see this by the monitoring nodes. Then a short hint to the web interface. This is actually the web interface. I already logged in here, and what I can see here is when I go to my probes, the first probe I can see here. Should I scroll a bit? I can scroll. The first probe that I see here is the one I'm running at the university. And all the other ones, I didn't see them last week because then I did not have the other ones. All those are the ones we registered to me and handed out to you. And as you can see here, this is his node here. He already connected it today in the morning, so it's up. And I will use his node to do a short demo. As you can see here, you get some basic information, the firmware information and so on. It's the node is connected since about 7 today in the morning. Get up early. And you get some basic measurements. There are some default measurements from the RIPE. For example, they are pinging the K root server, they are pinging the name server of RIPE, and so on. And you also can add private measurements. For example, at my node, I have some measurements, for example, for my DNS server, so my NTP server I'm running. Yeah, what else? Adding a new measurement is as easy as going to my measurements and creating a new measurement here. You can choose the type of the measurement you want to do. For example, I want to ping somewhere, enter the target where you want to ping, ns.ripe.net, for example. You can give it a basic description and so on. Go to next. Then you can choose, that's really interesting, you can choose the origin from where you want to do that measurement. So you never do measurements from your probe. You are doing measurements from the other probes. And you get credits using the other probes for giving your probe getting used by other ones. So it's a balanced system. And now I can say from which source I want to ping that name server that I just created. So I say area, and then I can choose an area from which I want to do that measurement. And now I can say, for example, West US, Northern or Southern US or something. And I can say worldwide. So I'm doing the measurement worldwide. I want the measurement to be done by, let's say, 5 probes. Now 5 random probes worldwide are selected doing the measurement for me. So they can be anywhere worldwide. I also can choose an autonomous system. I can choose a specific autonomous system or can choose any autonomous system, and it will select any probe in that autonomous system to monitor the measurement I want to do. Well, I go to next, and I can say when it should start and when it should end the measurement. And I think it could be that this won't work, right? Because I have too many measurements at this specific node. But this is because I didn't prepare this well here. So just click the next button, then you then you get the measurement added to the measurements list. And as you can see here, I'm running a Tor server, so I'm pinging the Tor server from 5 probes worldwide. And if I click here, I'm getting fancy graphs for this. The status is connected, the measurements are public, and where are my measurements? I'm not sure. As I told you, I'm not very well prepared for this. But somewhere I get a map where I can see the probe that is measuring me, and also I should get some fancy graphs, but I'm not exactly sure where to click at the moment. Yes, there is a public API at the RIPE website. You can completely control this by REST calls using JSON data. So every measurement, every probe information, everything you can do in the RIPE web interface is also able to do via the RIPE API. And there is an excellent documentation on this. So just go to atlas.ripe.net and you get all the information. But this would maybe also be an interesting aspect for the next Google Summer of Code project. Maybe we should keep that in mind.
Maybe it's enough to take the web page monitor. If you have a company which has a web server, basically a web server, and you register for measurements from Germany, for example, so you can see how your customers from Germany are reaching your web servers.
That would be an interesting project, of course. Yes, right. Another idea we had, we actually liked that probes here very, very well. And it's tiny, it's very energy efficient. And at the moment, Christian Pape, who is also here, he was the man who did the VMware monitoring with Ronnie. We thought about creating a hardware device that can be used as an OpenMS remote poller. That's as easy to use as this tiny probe. I think this is a long way to do because you design a hardware, you have to produce the things, you have to make it capable of running a remote poller. So the 16 MB of RAM won't fit a remote poller in. But it would be an interesting idea to do this. So thank you very much. No idea on this. I'm sorry. So using using mobile devices to do the monitoring, or actually monitor the mobile device?
Using mobile devices, because this is great for fixed, but the majority of users are mobile. So what can we do to?
That's right. That's would be an interesting project, of course. Yes, I have no idea what are the plans of RIPE for this. I'm sorry.
Are there nodes in China or North Korea?
In the graph from RIPE here, I actually, this jump here in the graph, I got some slides from one of the RIPE persons. They used the exact same graph here, and they have a little note here that this spike is was done by Russia because they did an order of 700 nodes at once. So. There are nodes in Russia. I have no idea if there are many in China, but we could use the map to check it.
There's one in Kansas City.
Oh.
is it a common border like China, North Korea, Kansas City?
Kansas City, same thing, yeah.
Only one.
Actually, there are some nodes in China.
Cool. Okay.
Okay, thanks.
Great.